Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of our series where we compare our viewer-submitted VOD reviews from the Discord to our Radiant coaches over at skillcap.com to give you all an idea of what exactly the differences may be between these two players. And sometimes it can be hard to tell, and that's why so many players feel like they should be in a higher rank than they actually are, because they don't know what it genuinely means to be a higher rank player. But that's okay, let's talk about some of the differences between these two players, and then break down a few rounds from these games to help you all improve. And remember, as always, if you wanted to submit your own games for review, be sure to head on over to the Discord and check out our VOD Reviews channel, link in the description below. Starting out with our first round, which actually won't take place for that long. Yeah, that's right, that was the entire round. Now, this is a very extreme example of what we're going to talk about, but it also poses something important to mention given the role that Polaroid, our Omen, is playing. When you're playing controller, it's important to remember you are the only smokes on your team, and yeah, okay, the enemy jet forced up an operator on third round that's going to catch us a bit off guard, but it looks sort of like Polaroid is ready to take a duel here on B long, which is something a lot of players may try to do. So, is this a good idea? Well, if you have gun advantage, maybe you could take a duel here with a Vandal, but if you're sitting even with the enemy team in guns like he was right here, it might not be the best choice. I mean, if he does get an early pick, that's awesome, and it starts out his team in a good position. However, in this situation, what happened is he got picked off 2 seconds into the round, and then since he's most of his team's smokes, they actually don't have any smokes for the retake anymore. And because of that, it makes this retake very difficult, as you'll see in the background. Oh, and by the way, his team actually does have a Brimstone too, but he has a tendency to use all of his smokes immediately as the round starts. But like I said, this is an extreme example, and it's unfortunate that the jet ended up having an operator so early, but when you're playing a role like controller, it's actually super important that you stay alive, and I'd say even more so than any duelist, initiator, or sentinel in many situations. Having smokes is such a necessary thing, and it really sucks that he got picked off this early into the round. One way he could have avoided this as well is if he decided to use his teleport to play an off angle on top of yellow or maybe even on top of the gray box. When you have tools like this available in your kit, I highly recommend taking advantage of them, and it's really important to remember in these matches, it's not always about making it easiest for you to hit your shot, it's also about making it more difficult for your enemies to land theirs, and playing up in a position they don't expect you to be is a great way to do that. The next round we're actually going to take a look at, though, doesn't have a lot to do with specific Omen things, but it's something that I don't hear discussed a lot, and I figure it's helpful to mention to players. And this is going to have to do with rotations and something called slides. And no, I'm not talking about a PowerPoint presentation, but you'll notice in the background, Polaroid is going to get caught rotating in mid this round, and for me this very much just looks like it comes from a lack of awareness of what's actually going on in the game. So if you look at Polaroid's map, he's rotating towards mid, and you'll notice he actually has 3 teammates currently alive over on A. And don't get me wrong, if you could have a fourth, it would be easier to defend, but the thing is, his entire team is over at A right now, and he doesn't need to be on A. It's totally acceptable for him to slide over to mid and pick up the middle for his team while they defend A, because it's entirely possible for there to be a lurker currently in mid. It's okay that he gave up B because his entire team rotated towards A, but somebody needs to watch mid, and that's why the furthest player from A will be the one to pick up mid. Because this means that the player from A can rotate to help more quickly because they are the closest to A, they just need somebody to pick up mid. So what I'm saying here is Polaroid is booking it over towards A site to help his team when that really shouldn't be the first thing on his mind. The first thing on his mind should be, somebody could be lurking mid, I need to pick up mid and watch to see if they rotate. There's also this awesome angle underneath tube where he can gather so much info that he really doesn't need to be running towards A with his knife out here. It doesn't end up making too big of a difference in the long run, but this is a round that could have easily been lost due to some careless plays like this. Let's talk about something that most gold players are probably familiar with dealing with their controller players though, and I think it's funny because his team actually has 2 controllers right now, and they both are the exact opposite. His Brimstone, for example, you'll see likes to use literally all of his smokes the first time he sees anybody on the map. And this is a huge investment, obviously, but Polaroid is actually the greater of two evils in this scenario, and he's the player who really hardly uses his smokes at all. There are a lot of options for things to smoke throughout the entirety of these rounds, but there were so many rounds I watched him that he'd have 2 smokes in his inventory and chose to dry swing an angle instead. In this round, you'll notice he sort of chucks a smoke into the middle of nowhere, and honestly, this was one of the few smokes that he used on defense, so it's really hard to complain because at least he smoked. If you don't know where to smoke on defense though, there's a bunch of things to keep in mind. You can always smoke the entrance of wherever you're defending to make it difficult for the enemies to rush you. This will also force them to use more utility lead, which is nice for later in the round. You can also throw smokes wherever your team is getting pushed, so if your A players need a smoke after Brimstone uses all of his in the first 20 seconds, you can definitely help them there. And then of course the obvious example is for retakes. Rather than throwing a smoke literally right next to Generator, why not throw a smoke on top of Pipes? And he still had one smoke in this round, and I'm not saying that the smoke on Pipes would have saved his life here, but maybe in another scenario it would, and it's just frustrating as a controller main myself to see situations like this where it just feels like the player doesn't know exactly how to use their smokes. There wasn't a bunch of Omen stuff going on in these rounds though, so let's take a look at another round from Polaroid where he raises a few red flags that are worth commenting on. And this round is actually going to take place on the last round of the game, which is awesome, as you'll see they end up winning. They win the game, and that's great. But pay attention to how Polaroid uses his utility throughout this round. He sort of just throws his smokes out whenever, without really ever communicating it with his team. And not only that, but pay attention to his blind here. Now, I actually don't hate it entirely. What I do hate, though, is that it very much feels like whenever he uses his blinds or his smokes throughout the game, it doesn't ever feel like they were meant for his team, and they were more meant for him. Which, don't get me wrong, a great part about playing Omen is that he can actually flash for himself if he needs to. However, he's still a support agent, and you can get a ton of value flashing for your team, and it doesn't ever feel like this is something that's on Polaroid's mind. It more so feels like he only ever thinks about blinding when he's like, I could benefit from a blind right now. Take a look at Floshizzle now. Floshizzle is our Radiant Omen player for today. He's a super strong player and is a content creator for Andbox, and he's going to be playing Omen on Split during this game. This is actually from a Smurf commentary available on our website, where you'll hear him talk through his thought process behind the plays and why he uses his utility the way that he does. Specifically, what I want you to do for a few seconds here though is take a look at his blinds throughout the rounds. He for sure uses his blind for himself like he did in the first round, but he also very frequently will use it for his teammates. Take a look at this round. The first thing I'd like to point out is notice how Flo is prepared at literally the start of the round to drop smokes for his teammates on A. A is very far away from him, and if he needs a smoke, he wants to be able to get it out to them as fast as possible. Is there any reason for him to not be hovering a smoke at the start of the round? Well, maybe if he's looking to take a fight with a teammate, he wouldn't want to be in shadow form, but for the most part, you can absolutely be prepared for a smoke for your teammates at pretty much the start of every single round. Next one I want you to do is take a look at Flo's blind here that he uses to help his Reyna get a kill. You'll even notice he doesn't actually try to peek off the blind himself, because he recognizes that that could be dangerous and he's literally just only throwing the blind to help his Reyna secure a kill. This absolutely isn't the only time that Flo uses his blind like this in the game though, and he's constantly paying attention to his map and how he can assist his teammates as a controller, and this is one of the big things that separates an average controller main from a Radiant one. Just their awareness of what is going on and what could be going on at all times, and then how they can manipulate that to their advantage. Now, I'd really love for you to take a look at this next round from Floshizzle, and I want you to pay attention to how boring everything that he does is.
To see where my teammates are ready, and I'm gonna smoke, and then flashing for my team pillar. And Phoenix misses the Molly here, so we're gonna push up behind it. Watching rafters here. There's everyone dead. I'm gonna hold the flank. What the fuck? Flank dead. Nothing happened, and I'm gonna. One last guy there. And then the jump, right click.
Oh my god, did you see how boring that was? He put down smokes and then blinded for his team, and somehow he picked up a 3K. Well, he picked up the 3K because he tried to protect the bomb planter and then went to watch flank, but these are the types of things that you're going to have to do when you're playing controller. This is your job, to make sure your team has smokes and blinds and to hold the angles that your entries can't while they're clearing other angles. Floshizzle gets a lot of kills in this game, and very few of them are actually from him just styling on people. Most of the time he's literally just dropping good smokes for his team, and then his enemies are trying to push through these smokes and end up getting themselves killed. Take a look at this compilation from Floshizzle's game real fast, just to get an idea of how most of this game went. And this isn't to say you can never pull off some heroics when you're playing an agent like Omen or any other controller, but it's important to remember your role. And your role as a controller is to place your smokes to help your team. That's why so many of these agents can do it from across the map. Omen, Astra, even Viper can constantly be assisting their team without necessarily being there. And that's why the biggest difference you're going to see between these two players is that one of them is constantly aware of what's going on and then how they can help their team, and the other one is mostly only thinking about how they can help themselves. And I think that's an aggressive statement. Obviously, Polaroid does think about how he can help his teammates, but the frequency that he does it doesn't seem to be on par with the better controller players in the game you may see. And if you're ever looking to improve your controller game, the best place to start is with your smokes. They are one of the most important things in the game, and the best controllers you can have on your team are the ones who see that you need a smoke and place it without having to be asked. And that's the kind of player that Flowshizzle is. So what are you waiting for? If you want to see this game with all of Flow's commentary, be sure to head on over to skillcap.com and check it out, along with all the other content featuring VOD reviews and other micro commentaries that you can't find available on the YouTube. All of that is just a few clicks away. Thank you all for watching. I hope this was helpful for some of you. And as always, my name is King, and we here at SkillCapt want to thank you all for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.